Once more she was human upon earthly soil, in the muttering night amid the rains of Tours and the rude cottage where she sat in trance. That subtle world withdrew deeply within, behind the sun veil of the inner sight. But now, well, this has happened, but still something has opened out in her heart. Hriday Kamala has slightly opened out here. Half open lotus bud of the heart had bloomed and stood disclosed to the earthly ray. He says half open. You see that half is important. It's not fully open. It's not fully open, it's half open, because that part is over, but what about the other part? What about the other part?
She's working on her soul.
Soul is not all. See, soul is, so that is the half of it. But the other half of your nature, of your whole thing, which is all here around, what about that? That has also to open out. And that is what is going to happen. But now, the half-opened lotus bud of her heart had bloomed and stood disclosed to the earthly ray. In an image, shone, revealed her secret soul. There was no wall severing the soul and mind. That's the beauty of it now. Mind is open to the soul. No mystic fence guarding from the claims of life. In its deep lotus home of her being sat, in its deep lotus home, her being sat. Her being sat in the lotus home. As if on a concentration's marble seat, in the seat of meditation, calling the mighty mother of the world to make this earthly tenement her house. So that is the next half to be opened out. One half has opened. In her deep home of the lotus, her central being is seated there. But now that has to work out other part of it, the other half of it also. Calling, she has to call down the mighty mother of the world to make this earthly tenement. Yes, please come down and live on this earth here, in this terrestrial world, you see. As in a flash from a supernal light, heavenly light, celestial light, a living image of the original power, a face, a form came down into her heart. So that lotus has opened out, and something now from above is entering into her heart, where that opening has come out. When the heart's lotus has opened, then the supreme power can come and sit there. As in a flash from a supernal light, a living image of the divine Savitri, of the original power, that's the original power. A face, a form came down into her heart and made of it its temple and pure abode, made of it, of that heart. Is of that heart a temple and pure abode for the original power. But when his feet had touched the quivering bloom, that bloom which is now opened out here, his feet of that original power, of that supernal light, when it touched his feet, at touch the quivering blue, a mighty movement rocked the inner space, as if a world was shaken and found its soul out of the inconscient, soulless mind's night. A flaming serpent rose, released from sleep. So this has opened out. The divine power is pressing her feet in the heart, and with that pressure, this flaming serpent is getting awakened. This is the beginning of Savitri's Kundalini getting awakened. A flaming serpent rose, released. Until now it was asleep. Now the beauty here is, now we have got the entire description of the Kundalini, of the serpent power which is there in our subtle body. The beauty of this whole thing is, all this is happening in the case of Savitri after she has found her soul. That is the most important thing. Once you have found the soul, then if the divine power enters in you and awakens your latent energies, then it is safe. It is then, everything is then in the hands of the divine power. Otherwise, you can get lost, you can get betrayed, you can be gone totally, you see. There is the absolute safety of the divine power working in the human nature when the soul is fully awake. The diffusion of divine Savitri and human Savitri is such that with the awakening of these lower energies, it will not get shaken over. It will not get affected. She will not get betrayed by anything at all, you see. That is the absolute safety. That is the sunlit path. Awaken your soul first and then do all these things, you see. Therefore, before you start Kundalini Yoga, see that this is achieved. Before we start the Kundalini Yoga, half-opened lotus of the heart is there. When that opens out, then the divine energy enters in and then it awakens all the latent energies which are there within you. Without that divine energy, without that divine presence there, if the latent energies rush up, they will kill you, spoil you, destroy you. This is a great danger, you see. In fact, that is the big lesson here. Don't rush to Kundalini Yoga without realizing your soul. A flaming serpent, obviously he is a bright, beautiful serpent, divine serpent himself, fully there, lying asleep there, released from sleep, he is asleep there. Kundalini, a roundup, like that, sitting there deep within. It rose, billowing its coils and stood erect and climbing mightily, stormily on its way. It touched her center with its flaming mouth, one after the other. All the centers in the subtle body are getting touched by this energy. As if a fiery kiss had broken their sleeve, they bloomed and laughed, surcharged with light and bliss. This is what happens now, surcharged with light and bliss, when that energy is rising up and touching center by center after that. Seven centers, we'll see them one after the other now. Here. It rose, billowing its coils and stood erect and climbing mightily, stormily on its way. So, mightily, stormily, when the Kundalini rushes, it rushes with that kind of a force. So, if you are not prepared to bear that stormy might, will be gone. You have to have strength, adhar, shakti, to even awaken that shakti within you, you see. To be able to bear the impetuosity of this force. And climbing mightily, stormily on its way, it touched her centers with flaming mouth. Flaming serpent with flaming mouth. As if a fiery kiss had broken their sleep. There stands for centers. Centers. They bloomed and laughed, surcharged with light and bliss. Of course, they against those centers. Then at the crown, it joined the eternal space. So this is really what happened. This is the real Kundalini. In the traditional Hatha Yoga, Patanjali Yoga, Raja Yoga, the Kundalini rises from below and goes up. Here it is happening after the discovery of the soul. It first, the divine soul first presses its her feet on your heart, and then it awakens the Kundalini, and then the rest begins. In fact, you don't have to awaken it; it awakens by itself. Then, when the divine, then the crown, it joins the eternal space. In the flower of the head, in the flower of matter's base, flower of the head, lotus here, base down below. Now here, it is more than the traditional top and base of the Kundalini. In the case of the traditional yoga, the base is what is called the Muladhara at the bottom, and head is the Sahasrara head, you see, then it is from there. But here, matter's base down below still means the entire region from inconscience to the superconscience is being now swept by this flaming serpent rising from below. Flower of the head, in the flower of matter's base, in each divine stronghold and nature knot. Now, of course, there are different names for these centers. They are called sometimes knots, they are sometimes called folds, which protect you against adversaries. Fort. To protect you, fort is called a fort also. It's called a knot also, granthi, knot. It is called a lotus. It is called a chakra wheel. So all these are simultaneously. Seven forts, seven knots, seven chakras, seven lotuses. In each divine stronghold, therefore he is using stronghold in the context of fort. Each is a fort protecting you against adverse forces. It held together the mystic stream which joined the viewless summits and the unseen depths. Now this is the sweep of this flaming serpent. Viewless summits, perhaps even far, far, far above the head, Sahasrara. Unseen depths, down below, into the inconscience. And these two ends are joined by whom? By the mystic stream. The superconscient and the inconscient, they are joined by the serpent energy, which is now flowing like a stream. Flowing like a stream. It held together the mystic stream. Mystic, obviously, is all happening in the world, in the occult world. We join the viewless summit. See, in fact, in the Veda, there is a description. He is describing, the Rishi is describing the creator, or whom should we call the whole thing, whose neither the head or the feet are visible. Neither the head nor the feet are visible. What you see is something only in between, the interim part of it. The superconscious is beyond your gaze. The inconscience is not accessible to you. So either you are seeing a person, a being, whose neither the head nor the feet you can see. This is what you have got. Viewless summits and the unseen depths. The string, you see, there you are, forts. You see, these are the forts, you see. The string of forts that make the frail defense, safeguarding us against the enormous world. So this is the medieval image fort for the army protection and all that, against the enemy. Our lines of celebration in its vast, an image set of the original power. We had that thing earlier also. Image of the original power. It is that image of the original power now, an image set of the original power wearing the mighty mother's form and face. So she is there herself present, therefore nothing wrong can go. No evil, no style can attack you. So this is what has happened. The moment in the half-open lotus of her heart, the divine power pressed her feet on it. Suddenly the serpent rose, and then the mighty mother is standing there behind. An image sat of the original power, wearing the mighty mother's form and face.